Heaven Official's Blessing, Chapter 59, Audio Source, WuxiaWorldAudiobook.com. On the Marshall Deity Avenue, an awe-inspiring first impression. This child was no older than 7 or 8, and quite the gaunt and small creature. Falling from such a height, his little body was shaking uncontrollably in his arms like a newborn of an animal. However, from that mess of bandages wrapped around his head peeked a large eye black in color, reflecting the shadow of a snow-white figure within, watching him unblinkingly as if he could no longer see anything else. Loud gasps were heard from all around, and when Xie Lian raised his head, his heart sank. In his peripheral vision he saw lying on the ground not far away a golden object. The golden mask that hid his face had fallen. Xie Lian had landed in the middle of the Marshall Deity Avenue, and the ceremonial parade was miles behind him, the procession not having made it that far yet. The sudden commotion broke the steady march of the warriors. The flower-tossing celestial fairies looked panicked. The golden carriages stopped, a number of white stallions stomped their hooves and neighed in alarm, and the strings missed notes and their rhythms disrupted. Some kept going, and some stopped. Without being able to coordinate their march again, the entire situation was going out of control. The crowd on both sides of the street still haven't had the chance to react. But the King of Xi'an Le upon the towering platform stood up immediately, watching his son's silhouette, his expression worried and grave. The moment he stood, how could the rest of the nobles remain seated? So they all rose to their feet in a frenzy. The head priest's bottom had only just warmed his seat, but now it's cold again. He was rapidly thinking whether if he need to prostrate on all fours immediately to beg for forgiveness, and Qi Rong had already leapt onto the railing, his sleeves rolled up, shouting in rage. What's going on now? What's happening? Why did the procession fall into chaos? What the hell are you useless trash doing? Did you all eat nothing but plain rice, so dumb you can't even hold your horses? The queen's face was pale, her brows slightly knitted, and hurriedly sent for another to drag him back. The crowds were growing agitated and a riot was about to erupt when just then, Xie Lian rose to his feet. Usually, the honorable crown prince was hidden deep within the palace or trang at the holy royal pavilion, and rarely had the chance to show his face to the people. This was such a rare occasion that many couldn't help but be intrigued, their gazes all falling on him. Seeing his face, they all held their breaths. That young man had long brows and charming eyes, dignified and handsome, radiating nobility, his aura blindingly bright, forcing down the eyes of those looking. With the child in one arm, he raised the other with a sword in hand, and pointed it to the grand stage. That demon had been observing the situation from above the stage, and seeing that gesture, he paused for a moment before leaping off the ground. The crowd wowed in amazement as the demon, his form like a streak of black cloud, flew across midair to the stone pillar where the saber was deeply embedded, pulled it out from the crack, then flipped again, landing in the middle of the street before the martial warrior. Seeing that he instantaneously understood his intentions and came forth to cooperate, Xie Lian lauded under his breath. Good Muqing. Now both the god-pleasing martial warrior and the demon had descended the stage. One black, one white, saber and sword clashed once again, heightening the excitement, electrifying the crowd. Upon the towering platform, the faces of nobles finally relaxed, looking appeased. The demon made the act to aim for the child in the warrior's arms, both hands holding the saber, gripping it to the side and rushed towards Xie Lian. The two faked parrying, moves after moves, strike after strike, and leapt back onto stage anew. While the crowd was distracted, Muqing used the chance to do a somersault on the street, grabbed the mask then dashed through the procession crying in a low voice. Don't scramble. Compose yourselves. Pretend nothing's happened and continue the march. Finish marching this round and return to the palace. All within the procession immediately steadied and returned to their own posts, their spirits renewed. The moment Muqing returned on stage, his attacks became even more vigorous, clinking and clanking. Xie Lian received more slashes. Just then, the child in his arms cried out, probably terrified by being stuck between the clashing weapons. Xie Lian's left hand held him tighter and whispered, "Don't be scared." Hearing his words, the small child gripped onto the folds of his clothes by the chest. Even with a child in one arm and the other hand handling the sword, Xie Lian was still fighting with ease. Parrying for another while, he felt the child in his arms raise his trembling arms and grabbed hold of his shoulders in a deadly grip, as if he's hanging on for dear life. Xie Lian soothed again, "Don't worry, nothing will hurt you." After speaking those words, Xie Lian called in a low voice, "Muqing." The demon facing him inconspicuously inclined his head, and Xie Lian struck. Thus, before the eyes of millions, the god-pleasing martial warrior pierced the heart of the demon, slaying it on the spot. Muqing, with his demon mask on, clutched his wound, stumbled back a few steps, struggled for a moment before finally thud, falling to the ground, and stopped moving. Above on the platform, Qi Rong laughed out loud, applauding. "Dead. He's dead. Cousin Crown Prince has slain the demon dead." While all this was happening, the magnificent heavenly procession had continued to march, and soon moved onto the path back to the palace. Because of how well the act was saved and the unexpected improvised act was exhilarating to watch, not only did the people not complain, but rather their excitement grew even stronger. Numerous within the crowd were shouting, "Your Highness," hollering, "God," and followed behind the grand stage, thousands and millions rushing to the palace. A few of the generals had to send out many more troops of warriors and soldiers to block the overly excited people. However, in the end they still couldn't hold them back, and the crowd broke through, pushing themselves towards the palace gates. The King of Xi'an called from the top of the towering platform, "Guards! Warriors!" At the same time, the hundreds within the procession all had re-entered the palace, and the giant crimson gates closed soundly shut after the grand stage, the colorful banners of the performance now out of sight. The people rushed the gates, knocking and slapping upon it, their cheers ringing to the heavens. Inside the tightly closed palace gates, upon the grand stage, the white-clad god-pleasing martial warrior and the black-clad demon both threw their weapons onto the ground in two clanking sounds, and collapsed heavily on the ground. Xie Lian was covered in sweat, and ripped open layers and layers of his elegant costume, and exhaled deeply. "That was close. Too close. I'm exhausted." Muqing also removed his heavy demon mask and let out a long breath silently, but didn't complain about being tired. When he looked over, he saw Xie Lian was still holding onto that young child and frowned wordlessly. Feng Xin, on the other hand, called out as he followed after the grand stage in a jog, "Your Highness, what are you doing bringing the child into?" That young child was lying over Xie Lian's chest, his small body frozen and unmoving, afraid to even breathe loudly. Xie Lian sat up. "What was I to do? Throw him back out on the streets? It's a mess out there. He's such a tiny creature he'd get trampled to death." He held up the small child and patted his head, asking casually, "How old are you, little guy?" That child didn't blink, and his lips uttered no sounds. Xie Lian continued his query, his tone soothing. "How did you come to fall earlier?" "Your Highness, the child probably doesn't dare to speak. He's obviously scared witless," Muqing said. Xie Lian patted the head of that young child again, but the unresponsive child made him lose interest, so he stopped patting. "So silly," Xie Lian commented. "Feng Xin, go find someone to take him out through the side doors when you get a chance. See if he's injured. His head is wrapped in bandages." "All right." Feng Xin extended his hand. "Give him here." Xie Lian held the young child up and passed him over, but before he could do so, Feng Xin said, "Your Highness, why haven't you let go?" "I did let go." Xie Lian was puzzled, but when he looked down, he laughed exasperatedly. Turns out it was the child who was still gripping tightly onto his clothes, refusing to let go. A few were taken aback and started laughing out loud. While praying at the Holy Royal Pavilion, so many devotees, men and women alike, tried their hardest to get a glimpse of Xie Lian, whether it be out of curiosity or devotion. But once they've seen him once, they'd want to see him again. If they could train next to him, then even better. They couldn't believe that a child at such a young age would also be the same. Guarding around the grand stage were many young trainees from the Holy Royal Pavilion, and they all snickered. "Your Highness, this child doesn't want to leave." Xie Lian also laughed. "Is that right? That won't do. I've got my own things to do. Go home, little kid." Hearing this, that child finally loosened his grip slowly, letting go of his clothes, and Feng Xin picked him up. Even when the person holding him was now Feng Xin, the child was still staring at Xie Lian with his large dark eye, looking as if he was possessed. Many who was witnessing this started muttering silently, noting that intense stare. Xie Lian himself, however, wasn't even looking at the child anymore, and only spoke to Feng Xin directly. "Don't pick him up like you're picking up trash, you're scaring him." Feng Xin put the child back down on the ground. "Enough joking around. The head priest is freaking out. Your Highness better think about how you're going to face him later." Hearing this, everyone stopped laughing. An hour later, at the Holy Royal Pavilion, on the Martial Deity Summit, inside the Great Martial Hall, clouds of incense wafted in the air, and the sound of chanting came in waves. The head priest and three other deputy head priests sat in a line by the side wall within the great hall, their faces clouded, and Mu Qing was kneeling before them. Xie Lian was also kneeling, but before him was no one but the golden statue of the great martial god. Feng Xin followed his master and knelt behind him. The head priest picked up that exquisitely crafted golden mask, and after a moment he heaved a heavy sigh. "Your Highness, Your Highness." Even when kneeling, Xie Lian's back was straight, his posture perfect and his head raised. "Present." The head priest looked pained. "Do you know that in the history of Xianle, having held so many Shang Yuan heavenly ceremonial processions, never once did the grand stage only circle the capital thrice?" "Thrice." Every ritual of the Shang Yuan heavenly ceremonial procession, every decoration of every place, had a meaning behind them. To have the grand stage circle the capital once symbolized the kingdom's prayer for the peace and happiness of the people for 1 year. Thus, however many rounds the grand stage made men, however many years another such grand ceremony need not take place. Not only signified good fortune, it also saved money. Having only made 3 rounds, didn't that mean the kingdom would only be protected for 3 years? The worst thing on top of that was the golden mask on the face of the god-pleasing martial warrior had fallen mid-ritual. Since ancient times, the people of Xianle had believed that the spiritual aura of a person resided upon the 5 facial features. The spirit of a person was on their face, and the best must be offered to the heavens. Thus, in the midst of a ceremony, the martial warrior must wear a golden mask to hide their features because his face could only be appreciated by the gods, and the mortals have no right to see it. The head priest was both furious and disappointed. The god-pleasing martial warriors of the past circled the capital at minimum 5 times, at most 15 or 16 times. You can do 50 with your eyes closed. 100 even. But you killed yourself dead at 3. Why didn't you just kill me, your master, first? Now look at you. Our dear Highness the Crown Prince is going to go down history, dragging me along with you. No one dared speak in the Great Hall. Yet, Xie Lian still looked to be at ease and calmly responded. Head priest, why don't you look at it this way? If that child had fallen to his death with no one to catch him, spilling blood on the path of the procession, wouldn't that be equally ominous? Wouldn't the parade still have to come to a stop? At the very least, the ceremony ended decently, and that's the best case scenario. Let's just call what's happened an accident. For a moment, the head priest's words were stuck in his throat, but then blew up. "You child. With so many royal guards on site, anyone could have caught him. Even if the catch is off and he breaks an arm, he wouldn't die. You could have just marched forward a few steps, perform a little flashier, and everyone would forget whatever had fallen and move on." Xie Lian raised his brows. "Head priest, you understand as well as I. Under those circumstances, no one else but me could have reacted as fast, and there was no second person who could have caught him without injuries. Let him fall, there'd be one dead. Catch him, and there'd be two dead." His words were confident and self-assured. The head priests also knew that what he had said was true, and couldn't refute. But seeing him kneel before the statue of God, looking like all was well and nothing was the matter, the head priest was all angry, all amused, and all proud. Before his precious, darling disciple, he just couldn't get angry, and could only pull at his own hair, and use the pain of his scalp to relieve the worry in his heart. After a pause, the head priest spoke again. "Another thing." Xie Lian inclined his head. "This disciple is listening. You did well today on stage," the head priest said. "But no matter how well you performed, you can't just suddenly change things up right before the start without a word of warning. Both majesties were terrified by your act today. Do you know what would happen if we missed the fortuitous hour?" Xie Lian knitted his long brows, looking puzzled. "Head priest, in regards to this covenant, I already asked for your permission before today." The head priest was taken aback too. "You've asked already? Before today? When?" Bewildered, Xie Lian turned his head and looked, calling out. Mu Qing. End chapter.